It's go time. So if I hear myself, I know it's working. Okay. Okay. What was I going to do? I'm going to do some Python programming. So exciting. The armchair GM. He's talking about traveler characters he's making on his channel. And I thought, you know, people are looking at my stuff and they're complaining that I'm not using the official Mongoose Traveler skill set. That's true. I use custom stuff. I use the Traveler game mechanic, but not necessarily the Traveler setting. So I thought, if I'm going to push my wares as Traveler stuff, I should at least stick to the Traveler theme. So I'm going to go into old code, recent code, and fresh code from a few days ago and just replace my made up skill names with what's the official skill name. So I don't have to hear any more about that. Everyone wants to play in the Traveler universe, apparently. They can't just play in their own universe? No, it's got to be the Traveler universe for some reason. Okay, so fine. Fine. Let's see. How do I do this again? I'm forgetting things. Oh, share. Share. That one. There's no audio. I don't have to share audio for this, do I? Okay, so how's that going to look in my muted live stream? Readable? What if I make the screen bigger? Yeah, it's readable. 720p, because I'm not paying full price for a StreamYard. Years, you know, centuries from now, people will complain, oh, that Shauner guy, he recorded and he did live streams in 720p. Not 32K. What would it be? Yes, you're going to go, okay, 1K is a little better than DVD. Then you got 2K, which is like Blu-ray, and then you got, they skip 3K, right? 1K, 2K, 4K, Red Ray. 8K is out, but no one's, there's no content for 8K. Next would be 16K and 32K. 64K, what? I'm guessing it would be 512K, right? 512K a couple hundred years from now. That's what people will be streaming in. If they wanted to. Anyway, I have to go through my, I'm going through my Mongoose Traveler first edition skills, starting on page 52. If anyone wants to follow along, I've got this admin skill I have to deal with. Why am I sitting so far from my computer? What is going on here? Was there an earthquake while I was at work today? Did my desk move 5 inches? Across my studio, probably. Why I keep looking at the delayed stream instead of the real-time stream. Gosh, I want to play this City on the Edge of Forever video, but I've got too many strikes already on my channel. How can I make this bigger? If I grab this and pull this way, what happens? I'm going to make it worse. Making it worse. Actually, that did do something. Pull this way. Now what's it gonna do? Oh, is it fixed? Are we fixed with fixed height there? Let's see. I'm watching my 10 second delay. Yeah, okay, so that's as big as it gets. My big old head in the way. How about if I do this? Let's do this. I don't need to be off in the clouds, do I? The clouds of Azun? No, I can be wherever I want, right? Where's my StreamYard thing? Where are you? Put me right here. Boom. That's better, right? Now what happens when I stretch? Stretch. Stretch. And then what happens? What does it look like? Oh, yeah, it's stretching. Good, good. Okay, so that should be readable when people hit the second icon from the right at the bottom of the corner. I can read it. It's almost as big as what I'm typing on my actual screen. Okay. Enough wasting time here. Three people watching, including me. So that's two people watching, including other people. Trick is, I need to be able to see the chat. The chat, man. I need to see the chat. Now, what do I do here? Drag that over to there. Drag it to here. There we go. So now I can see some chats while I'm programming. Kind of the reason for this. I can minimize this, right? I don't need this, do I? Minimize that. There we go. This is better. It's getting better all the time. Here we go. Now, where was I? Admin, okay. First of all, let's update my version of this thing. I'm using Python 3.9.13. Let's see, I'm using PyDice now. And okay, so scale English language. Let's take this out. Bonk. Any more default skills I need to look for? What do you do? I figured I'd wear my Shauner shirt. That way I don't have to have the Shauner title in the screen. People know who I am, right? Mm-hmm. Anyway. Yeah, I wrote this code, what, a couple years ago? Back in Python 2.5, this is Python 3.9, and so my hex code. And according to Traveler 5, you're not supposed to use O or I. So it goes H, J, so there's no I. And then it goes N, P, instead of N, O, P, there's no O. Because I's look like ones, O's look like zeros. So Mark Miller thought, don't use it. And it's kind of cool not to have those designations in the hex code. Technically, it's the E. This would be E hex code, but I just call it hex code. Oh, here we go. Here's some skills. So I need to global search and administrating. Okay, let's find that one. Replace all with admin, right? I'll just replace one as I see them. That way I'm not accidentally changing one I don't want to change. Okay, that was all of them. That wasn't very many. Guess what? Four careers have admin in them, according to my lore. Okay, advocate. Advocate. So I need to look for advocating. There it is. Replace with advocate. What I'm doing is, no more of those. So I've renamed most of the Mongoose Traveler skills to the way I like it, the way I prefer, but technically it was wrong. Animals. So animals is now going to be, I got animals. I have animals here. So I think I already have animals. So I'm good. I don't have to change animals, do I? Is there an animals training? Let's find out. Animal. Oh, there is an animal training. Okay. So all animal training is now training. Is that what I used earlier, yesterday? Let's do a replace there. Training, okay. Replace all. Boom. Next, we got riding. Animal riding. Where are you? So, all of animal writing is going to be just writing. Is that how you spell writing? I guess. Replace all. Fire away. There you go. Next animal problem is veterinary. I think I have that one. I don't have to change that one, do I? Yeah, I just have... That one's fine. What's the last animal on the list? It is farming. Do I have animal farming? Animal farm? Mean... I do. Change that one to just farming then. Because I looked at the notes. I, 2008. Who remembers RPGs from 2008? But last night I had to regroup. And I noticed that according to Mongoose Traveler, farming can also mean growing crops. So that slipped my mind, and for years I had animal farming instead of crop duster. But now we just have farming. Replace all. Boom. Let's save this nonsense before I forget. Are you converting this to pure 2E? No. This is a 1E based on the 1E stuff. I keep my 1E and my 2E stuff separate unless I'm using the boon and the bane roll. That's one of the few times that Mongoose Traveler first edition gets to do some second edition stuff. Drive my animal. Animal driving. In Mongoose Traveler, there's the flying skill, And that's a natural ability, but it could be also be an acrobatic thing. So we're going to run into that skill. I just know it. Next, we got athletics. Okay, athletics has coordination. Let me fix my coordination. Endurance, strength, and flying. But flying can also mean that you're very good with acrobatics. With self-powered flight. I guess in the future, people are going to have, everyone's going to have those jetpack things with the wing in their armpit as a glider parachute kind of a thing, like a squirrel does, and then you would use that flying skill. Because it's basically you that's doing the motion capturing. So what do we got here? So athletic endurance. I want to say this just becomes endurance, right? Yeah. So this whole thing just becomes endurance. Replace all. Boom. Save. I'm trying to do big things into small things. My skill names were so long, I'm shortening them down to like auto car driving. I have a feeling that's going to get shortened down to grav. I think that was the actual skill in Travelers, grav for flying cars. They had roto, grav, and wing, I think. Even with the new rules, flyer skill read out to be somewhat dated. Yeah. There's a couple skills I want to say that were added to second edition Traveler. Dexterity. I want to say there's a athletics dexterity now in second edition Traveler. Because there isn't one in first edition. So I'm guessing second edition Traveler would have five athletic skills now. I'm going to cheat and look at my 2E book here. I try not to look at 2E while I'm messing with 1E, because that then I'm staring at the future. I'm looking 8 years in the future when I stare into the second edition rules. So athletics for second edition has dexterity, endurance, strength. There's no fly. There's no coordination. So I guess they changed coordination to dexterity. I see what they did there. Well, I'm still going to go ahead and just use coordination. So athletics, coordination, I think it was called coord. I shortened it somewhat. There it is. So I'm going to change it to just coordination. If I can spell right. Is that how they spell it? It's got to match. Because when my AI goes over the text, it's going to have to match exactly what's in the book. So when I look up a rule in Python, in the Python app, when I look at a word, a keyword, I want the AI to bring up the page in the PDF where that was found. Here's the rule. So I don't have to open the book, look for it. I mean, I know where rules are in Traveler, but just to be cool, I thought the AI should do it for me. Well, not AI, but it's, I say AI, but it's not an AI. It's just It's just a text search function written by some nerd in a basement 40 years ago. And the algorithm is still used to this day. Let's see. Replace all. Boom. Coordination. There we go. What is athletic cord? Asking for a friend. It is, if you don't have the one edition rules, it's a full-on description. It probably matches exactly what second edition says. Climbing, jumping, no, climbing, juggling, throwing. For alien races with wings, let's see. Now, the text is a little bit different in first edition. So, in first edition, it's climbing, juggling, throwing. What else is it? Oh, there's jumping. And there's sprinting. Yeah, just doing physical activity, I guess. Doing things with your arms and legs, that's coordination. Like, I don't use coordination when I kill someone with my brain. But I use coordination when I'm, like, trying not to fall down while screaming and running. Like, if I run like a girl, I would expect to fall down. One of your high heels comes off. You know, the zombie's walking real slow. The girl's running. She falls. Her shoe comes off. She's like, oh, she can't get back up. Oh, ho, ho, ho. And then the zombie gets her and bites her in the ass. And she turns within seconds. Want to be a mech pilot? If you want to be a mech pilot and traveler, I suggest you get one of the vehicle books. Either edition, I think second edition has mechs. I know first edition does. Howdy, folks. Cherry, you got a vehicle book for 2E? Is Cherry? Oh, Cherry's here too. What does God need with an auto car? That's a good question. Why would you need auto car skill if your auto cars? That's a good. But see, when I wrote these stupid skills, dating myself now, back in 2009, when I wrote these skills down, I don't think they had self-driving cars yet, did they? In 2009? When did I see Old Man Logan? That takes place in 2025 and there's auto driving trucks. Which show? I wasn't on the show Saturday. Was I? No, you had, Shadow, you had the great show. I wasn't on it, remember? Is that what you're trying to say? That I missed your great show because I had to go to bed because I had to be up at 4 in the morning on Sunday? As you guys talked about sci-fi without me? You bastards. Okay, what's next? Okay, did I do endurance yet? I already forgot. Dang it. I think I did endurance. Do I find it anywhere? No, I already did endurance. Next. Next on my cheat sheet is strength. Strength. Do I have one of those? I got one. So that one immediately goes into strength. So replace that one. There was only one. There was only one of you in the whole freaking thing. If you guys notice at home, you you probably notice already that my careers are cheating, and they already have the careers written in this. The careers already have their skills written in them, because I handpicked what skills best fit the careers. Because this is just for quick NPC generation. I already have programs that generate NPCs using the official character generator, but I thought, I'm going to cheat and have the NPCs generated by a super, 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 super light version of CareGen for Mongoose. So if you see my skills listed this way for each career, you know why that is. And it also has the characteristic that you can increase or decrease while you're in the skill, while you're in the career, and then the number here. I want to say that's the number of times you can increase said characteristic. So I want to say if you're a merchant, your intelligence can increase up to 3 times in that career. But if you're freaking nobility, your soch can be increased up to 7 times during your career. Just because. These are NPCs. So one day I'll see if you can get an emperor out of this generator. I don't think you can. I think it's mostly just normies that it generates. But like, I'm playing a game. This will never happen. But let's say in theory, I'm playing a game and the players want a fourth player in the game. But there's only 3 players at my table. But they want a fourth person in the game. That's when I spit out an NPC, let them role play. They take turns role playing what that NPC does. He's like the fourth wheel in the group. That'll never happen because I don't let players role play more than one character in their game, in the games. Now, if they're running a game, the reason why I even bring it up, sometimes we take turns being the referee in our games. So sometimes if I'm not the referee, I have no control of what's going on. And also, stuff I know about sci-fi, they might not know about. Stuff they know about sci-fi, I might not know about. So it's always good to have different referees running a game, so you get introduced to all kinds of styles of sci-fi or whatever, you know. If it's always you being the GM for 40 plus years, that gets kind of stale, don't you think? One player does all the imagination. After a while, I think your imagination is going to run out. Or you could be the lazy MG. And did I say MG? That's a cool word. What does MG stand for? Module. The module gamer. If you're the MG, you just run a game module. And you don't have to think. Something like Radiant Citadel. You just run that. Just read a paragraph to your players and just have them make faces until you ask them to do a perception roll, because that's all they know how to do is make faces. Where was I? Did I do strength? I did strength, and only one of these dudes had it. Now I'm curious. Which dude of mine had only strength? Where are you, strength? Did it save strength at all? No. Strangle think. Okay, so Marines got to have strength. Out of all my NPCs, the Marines got it. What's happening in the chat now? Hang on. Oh, that's right. My dead name is Sean. So when I see it there, I'm thinking, what's going on? That was, I think, yeah. I'm looking for Shauner. I need to like focus. So ignore anything called Sean in the chat. UFOs. Well, again, I'll be at work the next day, so I'll have to watch the UFO episode when I get back from work the next day. See, I put my name on my clothes, so if I'm lost in public, people can at least tell me who I am. This poor Shauner. He used to be something. Now he's just a shell of a person. You just noticed that. You just noticed I changed my name again. What happened there? I logged into something and it wanted one word. It didn't like roll for sanity. It wanted short names like Cher, Madonna, Prince, Sting, Hitler, Shauner. I had to pick one word for my name. And because I'm linking it to all my other stuff, I thought, well, I went spend a few hours renaming all my stuff back to Shauner. And of course, the computer here, I haven't told her yet. She's like going on with this roll for sanity stuff. I'm like, no, we can't do that anymore. But she doesn't say my name very. She doesn't say Shauner. She says Shauna, because she's got a UK accent. So I'm gonna have to spell out my name so she reads it like an American would. You ever notice how when a British actor plays an American role, they all sound like they have colds? Have you noticed? So when you see an actress or an actor on television or in a movie and it sounds like they have a head cold, chances are they're either from New Zealand or from UK and they're just imitating the voice of an American. So I don't know why that is. Like House, he always has a head cold. Apollo from Galactica, always. Who else? Loki, that actor. Who else? The girl with the boobs from Star Trek Next Gen. What's her name? The Betazoid. The whole frickin' series, she had a head cold. She sounded like her nose was stuffed. But she's doing an American accent without doing her Cockney London accent, which I hate. I hate the Cockney lens. The London Cock. Who's the guy in My Fair Lady, the professor? What's his name? Higgins? Professor Higgins? Blast. What would he say? He would say stuff to her, say stuff. He would be in the other room going, blast that she devil. Blast that brazen hussy. Because she couldn't pronounce vowels. His ears were like hurting. He's hemorrhaging. How are you? You know, H's, there's no there's no air coming out when you say the H sound. Because there is no H sound in London. She's trying to... The candle's supposed to move when you're speaking in front of a lit candle, and the candle wouldn't move when she would talk. And he was like, this is infuriating. This woman's going to... Because he made a bet with somebody that he could turn her into a lady in like a week or something. Anyway, by the way, it's one of my favorite movies of all time. It's got excellent role play, and it's applicable to any role play situation if you have a professor and a flower girl as characters. But yeah, I can't stand the Cockney accent 99% of, well, not anymore. I hate to say it, but a good 60% of Londoners speak Arabic. So Arabic, it's British with an Arabic accent. Is British a language? It is now. Gosh darn it. So the Cockney accent will probably disappear. Because now you have the King's English mixed with Arabic. And Farsi. And the other one. And the other one. Where was I? Flying. Okay, which one of you bastards has flying? Flying. He flied. Oh, I didn't have, I didn't use flying. What did I use for that athletic skill? Oh, I used jump. I used athletic jumping. Right? Let's just look at jumping. There it is. Jumping, 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 jumping. So we're going to change that back to flying. Oh, good gravy. Do I only have one jump? I hope I only have one jumping. Otherwise, my jump space will be called flying space. The mysteries of global replacement. Change all jumping to flying. Or flied. Flying. Replace all. I'm going to do one at a time. Oh, come on. There's more than that, right? Do I have to go up? Backward direction. Backward. What? I thought there was a bunch of them. Okay. When I was flipping through all the jumpings, I think there was only two. And I was just going back and forth between two. Okay, so who got the flying? Speak now. One of you was... Oh, there's arrow flying. Ooh, that was close. Roto flying, flying. Okay, so there are some flyings, but grav flying? Oh, I'm going to fix those later. Why are we going up? Should be going back. There we go. Okay, what's happening in the chat? I'm gonna be like DM James. Oh, what's in the chat? The auto car. Yeah, that's true. A lot of people don't know this with skill-based games. When it says gun combat, and you have a gun combat skill, people think, oh, well, I have gun combat skills, so that means I'm good with shooting guns. Well, it also means you're good at stripping guns, cleaning guns, reloading. You're good at holstering, putting on taking the safeties on and off. You're good at recognizing ammo on the ground, what gun it belongs to. You're a gun nut, basically. You're good at hearing gunshots. You can tell from the gunshot what kind of gun it was. So, that kind of you could use the beauty with Traveler, and the beauty with most skill systems is it's the skills are generic enough to apply to more than just literally what the skill name is. With auto car, yeah, you could learn how to repair auto cars. You could identify them quickly. You know how much they sell for. Maybe you're good at detailing the things. Who knows? Maybe you're good at hiding bodies in the trunks. Maybe you know how to get out of a trunk if you've been locked in one. Maybe you know how the ejector seat works on the passenger side. Things like that. Johnny Cabs, is that from Total Recall? Or we'll sell your memories to you wholesale, something like that? Who is drunk? Other Sean? Yeah, the other day I was gonna. I was just going to go back to Sean and say, New Sean, you'd be Sean Cherry and I'd be New Sean. Something or something like that. I don't know. And then I thought, I'm going to. The other night, I thought I'd do a live stream and come on as Dr. Girlfriend and have Dr. Girlfriend's avatar. Like turn off my camera and just have Dr. Girlfriend's face on the screen. And the whole time, I would just talk using Dr. Girlfriend's voice. And then I thought, that would kill my throat if I did that for a whole 2 hours. Let's see. What does this NPC generator do differently? This one here, the main thing is it runs in your browser using HTML. So you don't have to run it from DOS. You just open up your browser and point to your local 8080 port. I'll put the link in the description below. But this is mostly for doing quick NPCs, and you get to roll when you make the NPCs, you can make them Nexus 6. Or regular characters, or whatever character. You don't have to use a 2d6 roll. You can use a boon roll instead of a 2d roll when rolling for attributes or characteristics, stuff like that. As long as you're still within the two, what is it, 2 to 12 range, or is it 2 to 15 range? I forget. It says there's instructions on the website when you run the thing. It says, I can't run this now because I've detached it from the skull. So I'm operating on the brain right now. And what else does this do? This just makes quick NPCs. You say if you want male, female, or both, or how many NPCs? It'll spit out 100 NPCs if you want. You just copy paste the ones you want into your adventure game that you're writing, or into your virtual tabletop terminal thing. So other players can read stats on NPCs they're encountering or whatever, stuff like But my other generator, the one that talks, that one's full blown. That one uses the rules for making Traveler characters. Because this just prints out the name of the person, their how old they are, how many terms they served in a career, and then it lists out the skills and it lists out their quirk. It doesn't list out their inventory. It doesn't list out their benefits they got, like how much money they have in the bank. It doesn't show any of that stuff. So it's very light. It's a very light version of a NPC generator. No contacts, no connections, no ships. None of these NPCs have scout ships or lab ships or free traders or what's the other one? The jungle ship. What's that one called? The yacht. That's the ship that the guy drives around in when you play the most deadly game. And that guy comes out. You land on this jungle world in his fancy little flying yacht thing. And he says, the ramp opens and he lets you out. And he says, you have 5 minutes. And you're like, 5 minutes to do what? 5 minutes to get a head start before I come after you. This is my jungle planet and you are my prey. And you do that kind of adventure. The trick is to kill him and get his ship and fly off without him getting you first. And there's all kinds of traps, poisonous plants, killer dinosaurs, all kinds of things on this world that he's engineered for his excitement. The point is, none of the NPCs generated here gets one of those ships. What's happening now? I wish I could scroll without my mouse getting in the way of what's being said. I've never run a module. I've never bought an adventure game except recently. About 10 years ago, I started buying adventure games. Just to see how they're written, because one day I want to write an adventure game and just stick it on DriveThruRPG. Just so I can say, I'm a published game designer. But I have trouble writing. I'm not very good at writing. So a lot of the stuff I think up, I have trouble getting it written down on paper. And then have to do the layout and the table of contents and the page numbers and chapter names. And I start nodding off because that just seems so boring to me. Writing is so boring. I'll read it. I'll play it. I just don't want to be the one who has to write it. Rex Harrison. Is that a character? No. I like how Sean says, I would have my computer chick have an Australian accent. So I only run a module. Why am I reading? I should just do this. I forgot. I can just do this. Duh. Okay, here we go. I only run a module if it's a starting town, but I change everything else. Oh, that makes sense. Yep. That's what I do. I'll read a module and just use snips of it for a one shot. But it's a good start, and then I just add, like what you say, just add on. Okay, so David has an Aussie accent. How'd you get that? Lucky? Okay. I take issues with this because I saw Mad Max 1975 and there are some Aussies. Some of the characters in that movie I just want to strangle from in front of the screen. But then there's some of the characters in Mad Max I'm like, I am beholden to this person and I will follow them to the depths of hell if asked to. Toe Cutter. I would go to the ends of Earth with him because he's charismatic and he doesn't have that annoying accent. Maybe he wasn't really Australian. He was the Joe guy in the last Mad Max movie. I forget what his name was. His last name was Joe, but I forget his first name. He died recently. He was like 70 something. But the guy who played Goose, oh, and the singer lady, ooh, oh, Mel Gibson. I have two versions of that movie. So I have Mel Gibson's accent, and then I have some unknown American voice dubbed over his face voice, which sounds very, very, who would he sound like? He sounds like Paul Newman almost in the dubbed version. But in Road Warrior, everyone had their original voices pretty much. They weren't too grating. But who's that one guy, the Crocodile Dundee guy? Did he talk like that on purpose with his annoying accent? That was annoying. He sounded like a country redneck hick type. Times Australian. Yeah, you gotta look for Shadow and Sun for that one. There's only one Shadow and Sun on YouTube, right? Hang on. Chicks on YouTube, links are the links or it didn't happen. There's Aussie YouTube. Is that a thing? They have YouTube in Australia? That would be weird. Who was the girl during, was it Korea or was it during Vietnam? The commie girl on the radio taunting the American troops day in and day out with her propaganda stuff. Something Rose or something. I wouldn't mind giving that voice to my computer for a day or two just to see if it gets on my nerves. Gun nut confirmed. How far did I lose? I gotta catch up here. Safari. Oh, the safari ship. Yeah. Why was I calling with the yacht? Yeah, the yacht, that's the one, the Shining Star or whatever it was called. What was it called in Battlestar Galactica from the 70s? Ray, what was his name? Ray something? The man with the X-ray eyes? Ray Milan. What was the name of his ship? Do you remember? He was one of the colonial, he was one of the, what do they call it? One of the senators. He had the yacht on that show. It was kind of cool. I'd buy that for a dollar. Okay, Mercenary Cruiser. I would like to have one of those, but I would need a crew. I would need more than 30 people to get that ship going. I don't have the money for it. And I would have to do mercenary stuff to afford to fly the thing everywhere. And remember, it's got two module cutters. One of those I can barely handle. That's true. Yeah, but you could, okay, David, you could say the same thing about Mongoose. Mongoose Publishing releases Traveler books on a weekly basis now. Sight unseen, not play tested whatsoever. Not even proofread whatsoever. It's very annoying that they send the books to the printers the day that they do pre-orders of the book. So you pre-order the hardcover book or softcover book of Adventure 3 of the Soleimani something something from Mongoose. The PDFs have already been sent to the printers when you're ordering that book. And the printed books are going to have all the typos, all the errors that are immediately found by everyone who has the PDF on their screen. Drives me nuts. That one I've never played. The ship looked so hideously ugly, I refused to go into the book and do anything with it. Immortal Joe, right? Or is it Immortan Joe? Immortal, right? I can't remember. You call that a knife? No, that's a knife. The Ayatollah of Rock and Roller. Oh, Tokyo Rose. That's right. That's it. I wouldn't mind having my computer talk like her for a day or two. Being totally insulting to me and telling me how far superior she is to whatever it is I have planned for the day. That I will suck at whatever I do. It's a tie. I don't know who that is. Should I search? Let me search. I like how you say, she's freaking hot. And then here's a picture of you, Sean. anything next to you is freaking hot. Her name's Julie. I already forgot what her name is. Julie Nguyen. It's probably a household name that I'm looking up right now. So far, Chrome is not name completing for me. She's not as famous as you think she is. She's a voice coach. Does she speak Australian, or she just knows the dialect? I'll have to listen to it later. I don't have my headphones on, so I don't want to blast someone else's channel onto my microphone and strike me down. And then I can't do anything on my channel for at least a month. YouTuber, yeah, I saw her face. She's got a red wig on. Unless that's her real hair. If it is her real hair, then I question your algorithm for hot chicks. Okay, this is foreign knowledge to me. Two girls, one cup. I've heard of this before. Is this one of those stripper guild jokes that Connell's always talking about? Two girls, one cup. That's like, okay, it's two girls and they're sharing a bra or trying to share a bra. And they both get one cup from each side. What? How's that work? Or have I overthought this? Don't look up the two girls, one cup. Is it 4chan or is it just Reddit stuff? Or is it just Bing? If I do a Bing search, it's safe for Bing searches. Don't search it. Okay. It doesn't involve cod pieces, does it? What about solo cups? Does it involve solo cupping at all? Where was I? Did I do the, what was the last one I did? Did I do flying? Okay, I did flying. Now we're going into the arts. The art of acting. Now, how did I do acting? What did I call acting in my game? Acting. Okay, I don't have to change acting. I don't have to mess with it. It's already acting. What about dance? What do I call dance? Oh, no one dances? Not one person dances in my NPC generator. Dancing, dancing with the stars, dancing, dancing. So entertainer, nobility, and rogue, they're dancers. Well, from now on, they're dance. Dance. Okay. Next is holography. I think holography, I've already got set up correctly. I don't have to change that one, do I? Well, the rogue has it, scholar has it, entertainer has it. That's it. I don't have to change it. What's the next one? Instrument. Oh, who's going to do instrument, really? Has anyone ever done a bard traveler character? Instrument. If I can spell it right. No one does instrument. How about musical? Musical. Musical training. That's what I called it. Musical training. Nobility has it. Entertainer has it. Okay, well, from now on, it's called instrument. I know. How exciting is that?
I have an instrument skill. I could play an instrument.
Why did I type that? I could have just searched it. Oh, I'm losing it. Where was it down here? Where were you? Musical training. I'm so lazy. I'm too lazy to type. Boom. Any more of those? Any more music? Okay. Let's save before I go insane here. The next one is sculpting. Who here has sculpting? Sculpting. No one has a sculpting. Not one person has sculpting. That means I renamed it to something else. Sculpturing? Maybe I called it sculpturing? No. Sculpture? No. I'm not spelling sculpt right. Sculpting. There we go. Do I need to fix any of them? So, entertainer has it, nobility has it. Same two cast of characters. I don't have to change nothing. Writing. Who has writing? Which of you brave souls has writing skill? Scholar, entertainer, scholar, entertainer. So I don't have to change that because it's already the right, it's already the correct way. Okay, what's happened in the chat since last time? How dare you? You've stolen my childhood. Holography is any kind of recording. Normally, you just set a device on the table and you hit record. And you would think it just records audio. But when you play it back, it's pretty much the same thing as in Star Wars. You set the device down on the table, you hit play, and it fills the room with an overlay of the scene that it had recorded. So you can walk around in the scene as you're watching it. And the NPCs and stuff and crap from the holographic recording are walking through you. Or you can get real fancy and plug the machine like a USB stick into a dashboard or a control thing on the wall. But then prepare to have a fusion reactor installed in your house, because now it's replicating matter in the room, and the scene that it's playing back are using real bullets. So watch out, you know, don't stand in the crossfire of the scene that you recorded. What skills is your rock star character? Players all play members. Oh no, it's Josie and the Pussycats all over again. There was a Journal of the Traveler's Aid Society article where you played roadies. Oh, yeah. Remember the guy, his name was Lee something? He was an old fart. He died recently, but he was writing. He wrote a module for Traveler 5. Cirque Ole or Cirque something. It was a circus. Basically, it was a circus, traveling circus through the galaxy, you know, for the Third Imperium, whatever, and adventures and stuff would happen to them while they were traveling from planet to planet. Anyway, they had a big old ship. I forget what the name of the ship was, but when it would land, the ship would become the circus tent. Everyone would go inside. And I remember Mark Miller wanted me to design the spaceship. So I did. But then he died. He died, and the book never got printed, as far as I know. Not the book. It wasn't. The Traveler 5 book was already out. You can still buy it, I think. But the this was going to be a novel based on that adventure book. So I designed the spaceship illustrations for the book cover and the book art inside the book. That was the only time I've ever seen musical band anything in Traveler. I mean, Epic Illustrated back in the day, back in the early 80s, had an issue where these deadhead types would show up at concerts. This was when movie theaters, the multiplex theaters were starting to be built everywhere. So everyone thought that in the future there would be 100 theaters inside of a movie building. I think the most I've ever seen is 30 theaters inside of a building. But when you make, you know, a theater with six, you know, if you split up a Cinerama theater into six smaller theaters, your brain just says, oh, in the future, we're going to have 100 theaters in one of these places. That never happened, as far as I know. But in that issue of Epic Illustrated, it did happen. And this one guy, he shows up in the wrong theater at the wrong concert, and he just loses it and starts killing everybody with his chainsaw, just ripping, cutting people's heads off and everything. Anyone sitting next to him, their heads came right off. Nowadays, I don't think you can make such a comic book. It would get canceled if you tried to make those now. Yeah, Buckaroo Banzai, he was a band. Was it there in the middle of a song, right? And the girl with the crooked nose, she pulls out a gun. And they stop immediately because Buckaroo Banzai hears her do something with the trigger on the gun or something. With all the loud music and his own earbuds or whatever feedback sounds he's listening to, he still hears her in the back, way in the back, playing with a gun. And he stops the song instantly and says, is there someone in the audience who's having issues? That guy, yeah, Buckaroo Banzai, he had, his charisma was through the roof. Through the roof. And then Peter Weller started doing the weirdest movies ever, and his fan base kind of became this weird sycophant collection of girls, and I didn't care for his movies after that. What happened? He would show up as the bad guy in Star Trek all the time. Like, why? But then my hopes and dreams came back when I saw him on the History Channel. And it's like, what is Peter Weller doing? Well, he became a PhD in ancient world history or something. And I thought, that's cool. Instead of making B movies for the rest of your life, you've actually, like, he's teaching classes at universities. on ancient Greeks, ancient Romans, ancient Greeks, and he knows all the back talk and all the what all the hieroglyphics mean, and all the Egyptian stuff. He knows the what people did during the day back, 5,000 years ago. What they wore, what they ate, the culture, he knew all that stuff. That is so weird. So in real life, he became like a traveler scholar, level five scholar. Mean, most professors that get involved with world history go back as far as 1960, because that's when the world started for them. And all they know is that Chomsky guy or the other guy, the Zinn guy. Everything bad about America in one complete novel. Or what's that other book I got? Oh, what was it called? Rules for Radicals. That's what most history teachers read from is Rules for Radicals. Basket weaving. No, there's underwater basket weaving. What is brain dance? Is that where you're in someone's head when you're playing back the movie? So you're seeing it from their point of view because they recorded it with their eyeball or something? Oh, Lee was his last name. Yeah, Greg Lee. Yeah, Greg didn't know nothing about computers, so it was a pain in the ass emailing him and trying to get information, pulling information from his teeth. He didn't know anything about Hangout, Google Hangouts. He was like, how did he even get his game, his Traveler 5 game published? Who did it? Who wrote that for him? Because someone had, he had to have had a handler of some sort. I don't do handling. I don't handle people. Yep, I wish I kept all my Epic Illustrateds. But I'm sure if I did keep them, the staples would all be rusty, the pages would all have turned brown, and the colors faded. That's just the way it is. That's the way it is with pulp paper. It was glossy pulp paper. The same, okay. Maybe National Geographic's hold up well. I've got the 1969 National Geographic with Apollo 11 issue. I'm sure that's probably fine. But Time magazines from 40 years ago, I'm sure the pages are yellow in those things. Yeah, Epic was Archie Goodwin's answer to heavy metal. Because heavy metal had just come out with a movie, a cartoon movie thing. Marvel's like, hey, why don't we have a who's the guy? Mobius. How come we don't have a Mobius? Why do they have a Mobius? Where's the Who do we got? Who we have? Jim Starlin. We've got Barry Windsor Smith. We've got who else was back then? Who's the guy? All these famous artists who are now—they're all pretty much dead now. But in the 70s, they were gods. Some people got their start in Epic Illustrated. They were still around until the Great Decay that occurred 5 years ago in Marvel. Anyone working at Marvel as a white dude drawing for the industry was fired and replaced with some lesbian, black, clip-haired woman who knew nothing about comic books. And they would proceed to ruin the industry. So, Sean, did you watch any of the San Diego Comic-Con on YouTube when Marvel mentioned Ironheart? I guess they're coming out with an Ironheart either movie or a Netflix thing or a Disney Plus thing. Let me see if I can find that. Do you guys and gals know who Ironheart is? I don't recommend looking it up, those of you with weak constitutions. Oh, it's got a trailer. Okay, so the trailer for Ironheart came out for Disney Plus a month ago. And I'm afraid to look at it. Because I'm racist. Oh, Omni Magazine, my first introduction to George R.R. Martin, H.R. Giger, that Gibson guy who did the cyberware type stories. What did he do? He did Wetware, and he did Neuromancer. Is that his famous book? So David, are you a DC guy or a Marvel guy? Or I should say in past tense, are you or have you ever been a fan of Marvel or DC? Disavow. Everyone in Marvel is gay, and now pretty soon, pretty much everyone in DC is gay now. That's the, and so at the, so guess who mostly went? I'll give you one guess. Guess who mostly went to the San Diego Comic-Con this year? Guess what type of demographic would you say went to the convention in the droves? I'll give you a hint. They weren't normies. The audience participation was not consisting of normies. The opposite, the complete opposite of normies attended the San Diego Comic-Con. And they cheered and stood up and ovationed everything said by DC and Marvel. Well, DC wasn't there this year, but Marvel, everything Marvel said got a standing ovation practically. And it was just all crap. For the next 4 years plan, it's just all crap. Women, what kind of racist remark is that? The women. Comic-Con's always been 60% women. You have to have more women than guys. Otherwise, guys won't go to these things. But anyway, that being said, the women there were radical leftists and or social justice warriors and or fat, obese, pink-haired, clipped, rape-preventive glass-wearing women with the nostril hook thing in their head with the bowl ring that they wear. That's a sign. I don't like guys. So don't even bother. That's what it means when women put those things in their nose. Fan of both. I was a fan of one. And then something called DC had murdered their Superman, which I thought was always overpowered. Because in one issue, he had flown out into some star system, not this one, but some other star system. He just, whatever reason, flew out there, and with his own breath, with his own two lungs, he blew out a neutron star. I was 11 or 9, I was like 11 or 12 years old when I saw that happen. And I'm like, where's my Iron Man? I'm going back to the Iron Man. And I didn't, and then I thought, oh, come on, you know, I'm going to try this DC thing again. This time they killed off Superman because he was too overpowered. And John Byrne came out with the Man of Steel 6-issue limited series. And I thought, hey, this looks good. I like the home world. The fucking home world of Krypton is Traveler Third Era. I was hooked. I was like, oh my God, they've got cybernetics in here. This is tech level 16 crap. I'm buying this issue. So I did. And I liked the whole origin of Krypton and how it got exploded. And the whole thing about, oh, the queen, if I remember, she didn't want her son marrying some just some genetic random person in the streets. So the queen clones herself. This is the nobility. This is what nobilities do on Krypton. The queen cloned herself. And this was an arranged marriage. And the son shows up to he's the groom. He shows up sight unseen. Doesn't know who he's going to marry. He assumes she's going to be some hot chick from down the street. No. It's been arranged so that he marries his mom's clone. And he just loses it. He just loses it. Just fucking murders everyone there. And the whole wedding is canceled. This was back in 86, I think, when this happened. And I was 24-ish at the time. And 22-ish. And I thought, this is amazing. What is this again? This is DC? The fuck? DC's got something going. Because this is what X-Men had been doing this for 20 years. And now DC's finally doing something that's got drama. It's not just guys with capes going pow, pow, pow. There's actually some stuff happening, you know? Some role play. And I was hooked. From that day on, I was hooked onto DC. And then when the Batman Returns book came out, I'm like, oh. I didn't care that Robin was regendered as a girl. That didn't bug me. Because it was written so well. Her character was written so well. I didn't even notice. I didn't even notice that Robin was a girl. It was like, I mean, I knew she was a girl, but I didn't notice that it was a girl. I could have noticed, hey, where's Robin? Oh, she's Robin. Instead, it just naturally occurred to me, oh, that's Robin. Of course, that's Robin. No question, because of the way she was written. Not like today, where they just race swap, gender swap, skin swap, whatever. And they just, I'm Batman. Oh, you're Batman? What the fuck? No written introduction for how you became the Batman, just Batman issue one. 3 months later, Batman issue one. 3 months later, Batman issue one. That's DC. DC and Marvel's guilty of this too. Every 3 or 6 months, they reset the count back to issue one. Because issue ones sell more than issue twos. So they keep rebooting every 6 months. So you go back to the comic store and you're like, I thought I bought Batman 1. You did. This is the new one. New artist, new writer, new set designer, new agendas, new radicalized Democrat agendas in your stories. Okay. It sells, but no one ever buys number 2 after reading a number 1. And now it's to the point where every issue is number 1, number 1, number 1. Or they just keep reprinting the same issue over and over again with a different cover. So there's like 60 covers now for the same issue. Collect all covers. That's how they're getting people to buy crap comic books now, is to keep buying. Each week it comes out in a new cover. Which one? Dark Knight? Yeah, there was Dark Knight, and then I want to say he wrote, but didn't have the same artist. It was Batman Year One. That one was just as good too. I think that one was only a 4-issue series. But I remember buying the Dark Knight hardcover for my dad, and I got it for him for his birthday or something. He's like, he didn't care. He didn't give a rat's ass about it. This is back in 88 or something like that. I'm like, what? You are holding in your hands the best Batman comic ever devised by man. He's like, what? See, he liked Buck Rogers, Flash Gordon, Prince Valiant, The Shadow, The Green Hornet. Who else? He liked those old pulp stories. I mean, the Batman was around in the 40s, but he just never got interested in that. He hated the TV show as well he should have. I hated the TV show also as a kid. I watched it. Just the introduction part. I liked the jingle song at the beginning of the show. But then once the show would start, I'd change the channel. It's like boring, filmed in boring Burbank studios. Isn't that film just down the street from the Beverly Hillbillies? That's what I thought. Every time I'd see Batman, oh, isn't the Beverly Hillbilly Mansion just down the street from Wayne Manor? I can't watch this. I was like 5 years old or 6 years old, and I'm like, I can't watch this stuff. Now, I did like the corny Green Hornet TV show. There's a story there. The Green Hornet TV show takes place. How does that work? I can't remember now. Anyway, one of the shows takes place in the other show's universe. Like, the Batman and the Green Hornet don't know each other. They don't exist in the same universe. At least on the TV shows. They may have come out with a show where they have introduced both shows side by side or whatever. But there was one episode where it was either on the Green Hornet television set, there's an episode of Batman being shown, and they show Batman and Robin, they're climbing the rope and they're scaling the side of a building, and Hollywood guest stars are opening up the window and saying, "Hey, Batman, what are you doing?" And Batman would say, "Stay indoors, fair citizen. We're searching for crime." Now, either that was shown on an episode of Green Hornet, when the maid's cleaning the house and the TV's just turned on in the background in the living room, or on an episode of Batman, there was a TV set on and Alfred's cleaning the living room, dusting and stuff. And on the television set is an episode of The Green Hornet, and you see Bruce Lee kicking ass. That's how the two shows see each other, is from each other's TV sets. Anyway. What skill am I on now? Stop sending me on these tangents. Oh, astrogation. We are on When you see me look like this, I'm looking at the rules for Mongoose Traveler. Oh, don't minimize. How do I move my PDF screen? Okay, there we go. Astrogation. Oh, astrogation's easy, right? What did I call it, though? Because I know it's not called astrogation in my game. I called it astrogating. Of course I did. Astrogate. Okay. Find that. Replace with. No! Astrograding. Change it to astrogation. Replace all. Boom. Did it work? Heck, it only changed like one thing? That can't be. Okay, flip. There's one. So Scout has astrogation. Navy has it. Rogue has it. Scholar has it. That's it. The Marines don't know how to astrogate. They piggyback ride on whatever the Navy is using, right? Just like in real life. Don't you hate that when people do that with Traveler? Traveler takes place in the year 5623 AD. But with 1980s culture. And they speak English just like Arnold Schwarzenegger does. Where are we at in the chat? Women? I can't pronounce that word. Nose rings for the win? No, nose rings are a huge red. Yeah, that's true. Iron Man. Oh, I was going to correct you, but you were right, Shadow and Sun. Iron Man was one of the best. Keyword is was. But you can't get away from them. Yeah, that's true. Everyone's self-deprecating their epidermises. The original Red Wedding. Red Wedding. She read all the comics, like Marvel and DC? Was she a superheroes person, or was she more like a Archie person, or a... What were the other comics back then? Oh, man, I should know this. I used to go to Comic Kingdom, Comic Gallery, Comic Castle. Comics and stuff. And they had more than just... Oh, there was Weird Science. There was Mystery. There was Eerie. There was... Creep. The Creep one, Creepy. And then there was Mad Magazine, of course. Now... One silly 60s show that I admired, well, this technically was a 1970s show, I think. It was called Land of the Giants. I thought this is the best thing ever. But it came on Channel 5, KTLA, in static. My dad's telling me to hold, stand this way with the antenna. Don't move. Because the show would always come on when the sun is setting. And whenever the sun sets, that's when a static occurs on weak stations. And I loved that show. And I was in love with the girl on that show. And then after, what, 8 episodes, it got canceled. Turns out the show sucked. I didn't know because I couldn't really watch a lot of the show because it was hard to get stuff from Los Angeles onto our TV set. Because now when I watch clips of it on YouTube, I'm like, oh, I'm glad I dodged that bullet. But I had the lunch pail and everything from Land of the Giants. So it just made sense. My mom was at a thrifty store or TGNY or something like that. And she's like, you want the H.R. Puffin stuff or Land of the Giants for your school lunch pail? I'm like, they're both good. 60 cents for a lunch pill. Anyway, I got the Land of the Giants one. Came with a thermos made of glass. And if you dropped your thermos, guess what broke inside? Glass in your milk. That's what I would see often when I open up my lunch pail. Back then, this is what happened. Those of you in the know, or not know, back in the early 70s, when you broke your thermos, what did you do? Did you go to Walmart and buy another one that didn't have glass inside of it? That had the double-walled plastic? No, of course not. Everything was glass back then. What you did was you would go back to the store that you bought your lunch pail from, and you say to the guy, he was the equivalent of a pharmacist. In the store, you would say to him,
ugh, I need a new what do they call it? What are those things called?
What was it called? The inner lining, the glass part of the thermos. What was that thing called? Anyway, so back in the day, you had two screws on the thermos. You had the top screw that you drink out of. Then you had the bottom screw. When you undid the bottom screw, that took the whole glass thermos out. Because in theory, you had to wash the thing, right? I mean, I was only five. But mothers would wash the thermos for you so you don't get the gangrene inside the thing. And for 10 cents, I think, or 5 cents, you could buy a new glass thing for your thermos. When did that stop happening? Around the time that Hot Wheels cars were being made in China instead of Hong Kong? When did Hong Kong become China? Back to skills. Agreed. How do I show new comments? It's not letting me scroll down. Neat. Okay. Astrogation was easy. That was one fix. And so the next one is battle dress. So what did I call my battle dress? I called it battle suit training. Why would I do that? Battle suit training sounded better than battle dress. So technically, what does battle dress mean? That you know how to dress up in battle armor? Let's see. So if you don't have the skill, you suffer a minus two. That's it? So having a skill in battle dress doesn't mean you get to use it. It also means you know how to work on it. You know how to identify it. You know how to use what weapon against it. You know how to do upgrades on the outfit. It says here in the book, you can do a performance systems check on a battle dress. And for that, you need education. Well, you don't need education, but it helps. If I read too much of Mongoose First Edition, I start to get a migraine because it's using the antiquated, everything is a +8, +8, +8, +8, +8. The only target number in this game is 8. That's the only target number you'll ever have. So you have to do maths around your target number. You have to do maths around your die roll to nudge it towards the 8. So it's like you roll, then you add a number to your roll, or you subtract a number from your roll. It's just more maths. That's why I loved it when Matt from Mongoose Publishing, when he did second edition, he's like, enough, enough. From now on, we have roaming target numbers. Your target number can roam. It's not a fixed 8. So, and coincidentally, the target number is the difficulty. Voila! That fixed so many problems. So many chart lookups, so many die roll modifiers. All of that disappeared when they made the target number the difficulty level. Dun, da, da, da. So when you rolled your dice, you didn't have to do math. You just rolled and see if you met or bet your target number. Dun, da, da, da. Beauty, simplicity in itself. See, sometimes if you stare at old rules that you're rewriting, to make a new addition from. If you're staring at the old rules all the time, you get stuck in a rut and you just think this is the only way it's going to be done. This is the only way it's ever been done. So it has been written, so it has been done. Sometimes it just takes a third eye or a, you know, do something else with your life. And then come back with a fresh eyepiece and see, oh, instead of doing all this fudging of the dice to get it to roll 8 or higher, how about if we just make the target number move? Dun, da, da, da. Anyway, so the reason why I mention this is because in Mongoose Traveler, first edition, an average difficulty is a plus 0. You at home who are familiar with second edition are like, what's plus 0? Average is always 8 or higher. You know, an average roll is an 8 plus. Well, that's in second edition. In first edition, average roll is a plus 0. That means you don't add anything to your roll. Like an easy task would be a plus 4. So you're adding plus 4 to your die roll. A formidable task is a minus 6, so you're subtracting 6 from your die roll. This is the kind of nonsense I put up with when I was playing a first edition Mongoose, and I thought, even at the time, I thought, these rules are still better than Classic Travelers, by far. Except for these little speed bumps that were left into the game. I wasn't involved in the playtesting of Mongoose Traveler. I wasn't even a role player when Mongoose Traveler was being developed. I was busy at home trying to figure out what to do with my life because I had given up on GURPS. GURPS soured my whole taste on the hobby. There's voices in my head were saying, what do you do? What do you do? You're not playing GURPS anymore. What do you do? And one day I was at Barnes & Noble and I saw this book. I saw a black book. It was a black book. Hardcover. And from the side, it looked just like the Traveler book from 1982. And I'm like, I'm turning my head sideways because you have to turn your head sideways to read what it says on the bookbinder. And I'm like, no, they don't have the Traveler book here in a Barnes & Noble in 2008. That's just not a thing. And I pull the book out, and it's got that black cover with the red line going across the middle of it. And I'm like, holy, holy moly, what is this? It looks a little different. And I opened it up, and it said, Mongoose Traveler. I'm like, what is Mongoose? What the hell is Mongoose? Oh, Mongoose. They did that D20 Conan game thing. And I'm like, they're not using D20 in these rules, are they? And I quickly go, and on the first 4 pages of the book, basically, are the rules of the game. I read them real quick, and I'm like, I'm buying this. $39, I'm buying this. The rest is history. That day, I cleared my bookshelves of the GURP stuff. Put the GURPS books on a different bookshelf. And then started filling up my bookshelf with the Mongoose Traveler first edition, which is right here. It's all right here. All of it. All of the first edition books right here. All my GURP stuff is around the corner and through the woods to grandmother's house. And I don't even go over there unless I need a source book to read from. Okay, what skill are we on? Oh, battle suit training. So now it's called battle dress, right? That one's easy to change, right? I'm not going to accidentally change a whole bunch of other stuff in my game, will I? Replace. Oh, only 2. Only 2 people had that. Marines and rogue. Save. What's next? Broker. Oh, God. I hate that word broker. It. I have broker skill. Is there something else my character can do? 'Cause broker sounds kind of boring. I'm gonna negotiate a deal, find a buyer. You know, they have websites in the future, in the far future. I know this. I know this. In the year 5623 AD, they have something called AIs. The AIs do all the selling and buying, all of it. A broker would just be someone who sits there, hoping for the best. That's not our system. You know, that's basically what a broker says. When the astrogation attempt fails and the broker staying behind him is like, that's not where we're supposed to be. How am I going to sell this Romulan ale to this shithole of a planet? That's what a broker would say. Because the brokers aren't using the fucking AIs. The whole point of traveler economics is that you're dealing with uniques. You're dealing with exquisites. You're dealing with exotics. You're not delivering lumber to a lumber yard. You're not doing that kind of nonsense. You have stuff on board that is very, very, very rare. And you will die if people know you even have this stuff. The stuff could probably even kill you if you looked at it directly. Methuselah syndrome, or the Medusan ambassador, or Lizardo. What was the Lizardo? Lazarius? Anyway. The guy who was trying to go into the 11th, or was the 8th dimension, or 11th dimension, or whatever. But he couldn't get his lasers all to line up before he went into the wall, and they were grabbing him. Arr! The lectoids, or whatever they're called. He screwed up. He failed his role. But to get a flux capacitor from your house to someone else's house, it's kind of an ordeal. When it involves going, when that other person's house is in another star system, and you're being followed by the Imperium. Yeah. And it's illegal to even go the way you're going through the subsector. All kinds of stuff. Where was I? Next, oh, broker. Duh. I thought we did broker. Fine. What did I call broker? Trade? I think it's called trade. No, not trades. Good thing I didn't do a replace. I'd mess up all my jack of all trades. Maybe it's called trading. I called it trading, I guess. I should have called it insider training, trading. Okay, so it's called trading. Change it to broker. Just be done with it. Replace. One, two. Only two people had it. Rogue and merchants. Okay. Well, that was painless. I forget, these are light NPC generated characters, so not every NPC is going to have access to every skill out there. They all have their little subgroups of skills. I made them classes, basically. Each career is a class, literally. Like nobility. For nobility, these are all the skills that nobility can have. And for rogue, these are all the skills that rogue can have. Stuff like that. Next, we got carouse. Carouse. Now, what do I call carouse in my game? Doesn't ring any bells. Oh, I called it carousing. Of course I did. So let's fix that. Or I get lynch mobbed for the day. Carousing is now carousing. Got a lot of people had carousing. Lots. Taverns are still a thing in Traveler, apparently. Next, got comms. Comms is going to come from telecom. So telecom is going to become comms. How's this look, by the way? Am I still sharing my screen? Oh, yeah. It's blurry as hell. What happened to my bandwidth? Am I doing a Windows update on a Tuesday? It's not Tuesday yet. When I do Windows update, the streams get crossed. What I'm uploading and downloading. Computers is next. What do I call computers in my game? I call it computer training, of course. Replace. Yeah, everyone had computers. Everyone. Computers are very popular still in the far future. Next. Deception. God, how many skills does Traveler have? When does it end? Deceiving. Deceiving is what it was called. Not anymore. I got yelled at way too many times this last month. So we're changing it back. Make people happy. It is Traveler. I called it a Traveler generator. Might as well have the Traveler skills instead of my own made-up skill names. Diplomat. Once upon a time, diplomat was diplomacy. Where's diplomacy in here? Nobility, you had it, right? There it is. Copy. Diplomacy is now diplomat. Hey, what's going on in the chat? Kevin has spawned. See, that's motivation, man. Motivation. I need to get motivated. I got all the software. I have everything. I got all the software I've been buying for like the last 5 or 6 years. Installed Windows 10, ready. I keep updating it. Every time there's an update for the software, I update it. Haven't used it yet. I bought it thinking, I'm going to make those little, you know, those, the 9x6 books. You know, the Savage Worlds Explorer Edition. The small one. I wanna make a print on demand book that's 6x9, about the same size as a Traveler little black book. But with perfect binding instead of the stupid staple thing nonsense. Yours is one page. How's that work? It's just one page? No staple required? Do you fold it in half to get a 9x6 or what? Anyway. But then it would be two pages. Hang on. People are talking about lunchboxes. Let's start up here. Babylon 5. Oh yeah, Vampirella. I wanted her so bad. I didn't know where she originated from. I didn't. When I was a kid, I didn't know what a franchise was. So I don't know who owned her, who was the IP, and I didn't know any of those terms back then. So I would go to the store looking for Vampirella, and it's like, that's... You have this idea of what she looks like, and then you go to a store and you see her on a poster, and it's like, that's her, but it's a different artist? What? Because you don't know that other artists get commissioned to paint characters. And sometimes you see an artist and you're like, who's this? It's cool. I like it, but it's not the same style I was used to, you know? To this day, I'm going to have to wiki her, look her up on wiki. Because I don't know who made her, who thought her up. I assume she was a DC thing, but I could be wrong. She may have been an EC thing. She may have been a whole independent thing. Like an Eisner thing? I don't know. Adam 12 Lunchbox. Ooh! All the TV shows had lunchboxes back then. Oh, put your helmet on backwards? That would suck. That would suck. You're that guy, right? Who can amplify your voice, and whoever you scream at, they become see-through temporarily. Or their bones turn into slime permanently. And you put the helmet on that you're supposed, your apparatus thing, you put that on. But you put it on backwards, and when you scream, it totally turns your own body into jello. Bobby Sherman. Who is that? Bobby Sherman. That's not like a Rex Smith, is it? That's not like a Fabian. That's not like a Sean Cassidy lunchbox. Bonds. I forgot about him. Hey, Lancelot. Lancelot Link? Is that a video game? You guys are talking foreign. Stop talking foreign to... I don't understand the language you guys are communicating. One of my relatives is Mitt Romney. He's an evil bastard. You'd been working with the guy that... Was this a famous guy? This isn't like... His name wasn't Stefan, was it? There's a whole lot of ex-GURPS writers that are on drive-thru with their own company role-play games now. I still think all their best stuff was when they wrote for GURPS. Yeah, playtest. Oh, that was a Hunter. Was that his name? Something Hunter something. He wrote T20, I think. Or at least he was publishing it. Yeah, I forget what it was originally called. It was called Traveler D20 and then just got shortened to T20. Or maybe it was just called D20 Traveler. On the cover, I think it's something else. On the cover, I think it's just called Traveler. But it has a year. It's like What is it, like 200 years after the virus destroyed everything? Traveler 1248 or something, but that was like even after. I don't remember. Who was the broker in Firefly? Was that Mal's job? Or was that I'm thinking of all the characters in my head. You had Kaylee, Wash, Zoe, Jean, Book, River. I forget the doctor's name. The two other characters, they showed up later. When they were showing the origin of the show, they showed up later. They were more like passengers on the ship than crew members. Dealmaker, you think so? See, when I was 14 and playing Traveler or trying to play Traveler, I didn't know how to role play a broker. I kept thinking, Wall Street brokers. I kept thinking of that kind of stuff. And of course, since I knew nothing about Wall Street, I knew nothing about what even that did. Yeah, they got AIs now. They've had AIs for years since the phone was made. People don't invest anymore for 30 years in a company. Their phone suggests, "Hey, buy this company now." Okay, hit okay, bonk, it's done. Then the thing says, "You should probably sell. You want to sell? Okay, donk." They're just answering what the phone says. Selling, buying, because the app sees the trend and it's like the trend is sell now. Okay, sell now. So people ha hang on to a stock for at most a month. Cupid dolls. Cupid dolls. Okay, so each Cupid doll in the crate, guaranteed unlimited lifespan. Each Cupid doll is an artificial intelligence toy. You're hauling this stuff to another world, and possessing a Cupid doll on this planet is forbidden. And you don't know that. You think this is just going to be simple. Sure, we'll take your crate to this world. What's the address? You put it in the manifesting. One crate of 20 Cupid dolls. And you're illegally transporting such things to another world. Anyway, the things are really a biotoxin. They're meant to destroy the race on that other world. That's why they're illegal to bring to that world. The polymers are biohazard something something. Once the atmosphere of the world makes contact with the Cupid doll, all hell breaks loose. One Ark of the Covenant, three Beanie Babies. One lipstick, one set of nylon stockings. Yeah, see, I thought that was a waste of time because I vaguely knew what a bard was in D&D. Because I don't think there were bards in first edition until you got the one of the books that for D&D E, first E, I think had bards in there. I don't remember now. But anyway, bards are rampant now everywhere in every role-playing game. Just by another name. Let me see. What is carousing? Let's look at carousing for this Mongoose Traveler first edition. Carousing, it's a very short two sentence paragraph. Carousing is the art of socializing, of having fun, but also ensuring that other people have fun. And it involves infectious good humor. It also covers social awareness and subterfuge in such situations. That's it. See, in my brain, I'm thinking, oh, you have high charisma, you've got excellent singing skills. Maybe as a psionic, you can totally get a good picture of what's going on in the room. Looking inside each person's head real quick. So their examples here for carouse is drinking someone under the table. So you're using your endurance modifier. And it takes 1 to 6 hours to drink someone under the table. So you're rolling against the other person's endurance modifier to their carouse. What else? The other example is gathering rumors at a party using your social standing modifier, and it takes 1 to 6 hours to get rumors, hear rumors. So I guess the better your social standing is, the better chance of success. See, that doesn't tell me hardly anything what carouse does. I'm gonna have to go on the Webster's Dictionary, look up carouse. I'm sure there's better examples there. Okay, what's the next one we're doing? We are doing. I did comms, right? Computers? I did computers, right? Oh, drive. We're gonna do drive. Drive. Do I have drive already? I don't have a drive. So, what did I call drive? Examples would be mole. That's exciting. Mole. Mole trucking. So mole trucking is now just mole. Replace all. Only one person had mole, and that was Marines. The Marines are the only ones driving underground. What's next? We got tracked. Tracked. Not called tracked trucking, is it? Oh, it's called tank. I think I called it tank driving. Tank driving is now called track. Right? Tracked. Tracked. Next, we got wield. What on earth did I call wield? Car or something? Is it called car? No. What's a auto car? Autocar. Autocar driving is now called wheeled. How exciting is that? How the official term for that skill is wheeled. Three careers had that one. Next, we got engineer. What do I have engineer? Did I have one of those? Or was it called engineering? Engineering. Okay, so engineering is now called engineer. Well, I gotta be careful with this one because I might have more than one. I think I have electrical engineering. So get rid of that one. Get rid of that one, get rid of that one, that one. Okay, that works. Next is maneuver drive. How do you spell maneuver? Because I'm not using the British spelling of it. Maneuver. Oh, I spelled it right the first time.
Maneuver.
Yeah. Okay. It didn't have an O in it, like apparently the UK does. That's good. Okay, so maneuver drive. That's a skill in Traveler. What did I call it? What was my better name for it? Was it Gravatics? Gravitix. Why are we? I always say Gravatics, but it's Gravitix. Gravatics just sounds better. If replace that one. Oh, and only one person had it, and that was the Navy. They're the only ones with that. Only the Navy has maneuver drive? Okay. Next is jump drive. That should be easy enough. I think I called it jump space. So I should be able to find that okay. Jump space. Because not only do you know jump drives, but you know how jump space works. But then I thought, after reading Agent of the Imperium, jump space is kind of unknown. There's not much known about it. You travel through it, that's about it. No one knows much more about it than that. Only a hand people alive are experts on jump space. Those that have lived through it, that can talk about it without losing sanity. Fine, next. So who's got that? Navy's got it? Rogue has it for some reason. Scholar has it. Scout has it. Okay, replace all. Electronics. Sounds pretty simple enough. How much complication did I add to that? I think I just used electronics. I don't think I switched. Yeah. So I don't have to do anything with electronics. Life support. Did I make that one different? No. Life support is still life support. So far, so good. Power. What the heck did I do with power? Because I know I don't use power. Power is energy. Copy. No, see. Put power there. No, put. Yeah. Put energy goes there. Nope. Energy is now power. See, that's what I was afraid of. I got energy pistol in here, so I gotta be careful. I gotta be careful. So replace this one. Skip that one. Skip. Hang on, hang on. There's that one, there's that one. I've got energy rifle and energy pistol. Let me skip both of them. So technically, only one person had energy. So now it's called power, and only the scholar knows about power. That is so weird. These NPCs are so weird. Next, we got explosives. How did I do explosives? Why would I ever change them? Did I change them? Okay, explosives is still explosives. I didn't change that one. Flyer. What the heck is flyer? I don't have flyer. Oh no. What do they call flyer? Aerial flying? Do I have fly? I had to have called it something. Flying. But that's the, this is, this flying comes from athletics. Right? Got roto flying, flying. Well, if it says flying, I'm just going to keep it. Yeah, flying. Okay, I have flying. Why didn't it find it before? Did I type it in wrong or something? Okay, I have it. I have it. Why did it tell me I didn't have it before? So, I have to do it the old way. Roto flying. Is now roto. Replace all. Boom. Arrow flying is now wing. And grav flying is now grav. Gavar. Right? Grav. Oh, rotor. Rotor, rotor. Gosh, I can barely read that. Replace all. Boonk. So find all the rotos. Change them to rotor. Rotar. Save before I go crazy. Gambler. Tell me gambler is still gambler in my thing. I didn't change it, did I? That wouldn't make sense to change gambler to anything. Oh, there's no gambler. What do I do? What did I change gambler to? Gambling? Maybe it's gambling? Oh, it is gambling. Okay. Gambling is now gambler. Replace all. Phew, that was close. Gunner. I hate it when I renamed a skill and it doesn't exist anymore in the game. So gunnery. Okay. Gunnery is now gunner. Dun da da da. Okay. What's happening in the chat? Or did I close everything? Did I kill off my stream? Oh no! Did I exit my own stream? I think I did. Where are you? I gotta minimize everything until I find it. Where are you? Oh, how do I get back into my stream? I closed my screen. How did that happen? Oh, there it is. Phew. Let's see. Dun, 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 dun. Krausing is the best social skill. You think so? I try to use a deception or whatever it's called. Interrogate, if there is an interrogate. Convince, if there's a convince. Most of the Star Trek TOS was waiting to see precisely how Kirk used Krause in any given sips. Bum, 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 bum. He would do Krause. Okay, this is how good the captain was. He would do Krause across the vid screen to an enemy warship bridge commander and get her. He would convince her to beam aboard his ship. Dun, 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 dun. And then they do the soft focus, of course, when she comes off the transporter platform. And she calmly goes to the brig, escorted by Mr. Spock. And then they have a long-ass discussion in the turbo lift, when the turbo lift only needs to go 20 feet and then down a deck. No, it's going for like 5 minutes. And then you see it going up, and then you see it going down, and then you see it going left. But that's television. That's television technology. What? She was a human being once. Oh yeah, nowadays she's drawn by everybody. Just go on YouTube. Go on YouTube. Look for Drawstream Vampirella. You'll have eight guys all drawn Vampirella at the same time in a 1 hour live stream. Oh, Warren comic? Okay. Cause she came out right around the time that you had those movies like what is it? You know, the cool women movies from outer space, those kinds of things. You know, vampire women's from Mars and the vampire women's from the Venus and the Venus vampire queen of blood and the other thing and the she-devil from, you know, all these cool looking. And of course, they all wore the body, genuine plastic leather. What were those outfits called that they still wear today? The plastic. You know, the condom clothing, what is that called? Anyway, all the cool evil women from outer space wore those outfits with the fuck me boots, and Vampirella had the low cut front that went all the way down past her belly button. Oh, the comic codes. Where are the comic codes now? Anyway. Welcome to the party, pal. We were talking about lunchboxes like an hour ago. Gosh. One page RPG is a way to get yourself kicked. Oh, see, that's true. That's true. Lesbians and laser swords. Or what is that one called? Lasers and feelings. What's another one called? God, I got so many. The RPG drive-thru has a lot of those one-page. I've got some one-page board game rules. How exciting is that? But I want to do a role-play adventure. Not a game, but an adventure for a game. But I'm tempted to do the thing which is naughty, naughty, and that is include the rules from the game in the adventure, so you don't need the core rule book. But that's a violation of all kinds of things. So then I was thinking, well, maybe I can just add in my own game mechanic, but nothing compares. Nothing compares to Mongoose Traveler's second edition game mechanic. So what's the point of even writing a RPG, honestly, when already the best one's out there? People have tried and failed. No, how's that saying go? Many have tried and failed? No, many have tried and died. Nobody has come out with a better 2D6 game mechanic than what was come up with back in 2016 by Mongoose Traveler 2nd Edition. I mean, there's some close ones. There's some close, like TPS, you know, Total Party Skills. Theirs is pretty darn close. And then you got the Day Tripper one using the core micro rules. That one's another goodie. That one's a close one. It has just enough medium dice rule crunch, but not overly complicated dice rule crunch, and not minimalistic dice rules with no crunch whatsoever. Like, I refuse to play a D6 game that involves one die. That's pathetic. What is it, like a 13% chance to roll one side of a six-sided die? How boring is that? Where's the bell curve when you roll a one-sided die? None. Or a one-sided, what is it called? One six-sided die. There's no bell curve whatsoever. Okay, you got me ranting. Hi. Trying to do work. I'm trying to program here. Gosh. What is this? What is this? What is it? Not if he's trying to make He is trying. Oh, okay, the grips guy. Well, GURPS is the godfather of game simulation. And it could have been more than that, but no, it's just a mere godfather status. Because fucking Steve Jackson back in 97 had panic mode when he saw the MPEG 2 video or MPEG 1 video, whatever, the 640 by 480. AV, maybe it was an AVI footage. Anyway, he saw that on Apple, it would have been the MOV, but he saw that Brotherhood of Steel shot where the innocent, it appears to be an innocent civilian being shot execution style in the street by one of the Brotherhood of Steel dressed in full powered armor. So Steve Jackson got a look at that. That was the introduction that you see when you start up Fallout 1 for the first time. And he's like, he immediately makes a, sends a telegram or whatever to Interplay and says, I want you to cease and desist. I'm terminating the license for using GURPS in your video game. You guys all know that story. If that never happened, if Steve Jackson had a bone in his body, he wouldn't have flinched. GURPS would have been used in so many video games. Hassle-free. But no. Something called special, the special game mechanic was used instead. And around the same time, GURPS was on its death. It's on its death rolls at the time. 2000 was coming up. You could see the writing on the wall. You had Steve Jackson Games, and then you had something called Wizards of the Coast, which was coming up on the horizon. Wizards of the Coast had frickin' game stores at malls. What did Steve Jackson have? A headquarters in Texas somewhere? And maybe an Origins booth? That's about it. So he's like, he put his head in the sand. He released the, it takes years to do a source book for GURPS. So those, once those got done, the GURPS thing was done, the contracts were run out and all that kind of stuff. He's like, okay. After Discworld or Attack from Mars or whatever, that's it. No more source books. We'll just do PDFs, PDF crap. For GURPS 4 forever, just every day we'll release a new PDF two-page thing for GURPS 4. That's it. No hardcover books, no softcover books, no nothing. Warehouse 23, it's just gonna sell old crap forever because we're going to Mumpkin. We're gonna do Mumpkin now. That's where it's at. Magic card gathering, it's picking up pace. That's gonna be the future. All the Wizards of the Coast stores are gonna be playing Magic the Gathering. We need a card game too. Let's do this. Make it Mumpkin. It costs nothing to make this game, and we'll sell it to crazy fat neck beard man babies who live in basements. Anyway, where was I at? West End Games. Dan Scott Palter, that sounds familiar. When I did art back in 1981, I was fresh out of high school and I was looking for a job doing, I wanted to be a computer programmer and some guy at the college I was going to, I guess his wife was going to the college or something. She noticed I was getting A's in all the computer classes, and she says to me that her husband's looking for a computer programmer for his company. I'm like, oh, okay. So sight unseen, I go to this guy's house. He's telling me he's got a computer store. He's selling Commodore 64s. He wants programmers and stuff for Commodore 64. I'm like, ah, sure, no problem. So I'm doing this programming for him and stuff, not getting paid hardly anything. And I said to him, you know what? You need like a sign or something. Like, you have no logo or anything for your company. You need something. His company, this is the weird part. I, on a napkin at a restaurant somewhere, some dive restaurant, some cow steer place. Anyway, on a napkin, I drew a logo for the guy. And at the top of the logo, I said State Art Systems. And I want to say it was a planet Earth with a flying sub looking spaceship from Voyage to the Bottom of the Sea. That style of spaceship leaving Earth orbit, and in its trail, smoke trail, exhaust trail coming from space, from the vacuum of space, it said State Art Systems. Because State of the Art Systems was already taken. So the Better Business Bureau suggested, how about State Art Systems? No one has that. SAS. So SAS was like the logo. Anyway, I drew this on a napkin. Little folded, unfolded napkin. It was a folded napkin. It hadn't been unfolded. So it was like 5 by 5 inch square. Gave it to him. He took that stupid drawing to a print shop and blew it up and was using that in ads and magazines. And I said, what? You didn't redo it or have it redone? It looks like a kid drew it on an... Anyway. Good times. Let's see. AIs already do most of the trading on NASDAQ. Yeah, that's true. Yeah, the AIs are kind of smart enough to, you know, let's simulate a downage. Send everyone home early because they're selling. But then they see people would complain. Hey, you wrote code. You wrote code to tell the AI to shut off the network when everyone's selling, mass selling on a Friday. Because usually the thing is you sell on Friday and you buy on Monday. Well, now the AI is selling on Monday and it's selling more on Tuesday and it sells even more on Wednesday. So we're in panic mode. But we're in something called the Great Recession right now. So I'm not sure how that's going to work out. On the news they say, oh, the Dow went down $2,000 today. Without a blink, they just say that. Can you imagine in the 80s, if the Dow went down $2,000, you know what would happen? A depression. But I guess the Dow was way, it's overinflated. It's way up there, so high, it's like astronomical. What would Trump say? What was his favorite word he always used? Incredible or no, not incredible. I can't remember. Anyway, when Trump was president, the Dow was just going up and up and up and up and up. Dr. Strangelove. What's going on with Dr. Strangelove? Did I do one? My favorite negotiators was Corbin Dallas. Multipass. When he's like talking to the Mangalores, Well, actually, he's not talking to the minglers. He's like, he tells the guy to look out, count how many he sees. And then Carbon Dallas reaches around the corners, he stands up real quick, he shoots like five of them, and then he ducks. And then he shoots some more. And then he waits for the Mangalores to say, "We need a negotiator." And then the guy says, "Where did he learn to negotiate?" I think what did he do? He shot him in the head, right? The guy who asked to be a negotiator, he just shoots him in the head. Where did he learn to negotiate? One of my favorite scenes with Jane, you're spelling Jane wrong, by the way. Anyway, one of my favorite scenes with him is when there's all this fighting and ruckus going on board the ship, and Jane's trying to sleep. And he's in his bunk. And he gets up, and he pulls the sheet or thing, the quilt or something, something he pulls. He pulls off the wall, and you see his cool gun hanging there on the gun rack, and you think, yeah, he's gonna come out with his gun blazing and kill whoever's in the common area trying to hijack the ship. No, he just goes back in bed and puts the covers over his head so he can sleep with all the noise going on out there. The actor who played Jane, he was the only conservative on that entire show. But he just didn't say a word. He didn't say anything. Because if he did, you were canceled. Same with the guy who played Lieutenant Broccoli. He was the only conservative on Star Trek Next Generation. But he didn't say anything. Because if he did, he would get canceled. Same with Janeway. She was a conservative, but she opened her big mouth. So she was always getting in trouble with the cast and crew. But she had a contract, so they couldn't. She was captain of the Voyager thing, so she couldn't get canceled. She had a contract, so they all had to put up with her. Who did the Dr. Strangelove quote? I don't remember. Well, that's from drinking someone under the table. What is that from? That's from James Cagney or Jimmy Stewart. One of those old 30s movies. Or Clark Gable. Maybe it was a Clark Gable movie. It happened last night or it happened. What was that one? She sticks her leg out to get. He's hitchhiking and cars are just passing him by. And then the girl sticks her leg out, pulls up her skirt, and the car goes. You hear the squealing tires. That's how they got their ride. Or was it who was the lesbian chick thing? What was that movie called? Sounds very vague. 1970s personal something person no personal best no the granddaughter of the guy who wrote the books about the bull running. What was his name? Anyway, he was a severe alcoholic. He wrote all kinds of books. What was his name? Hemingway. Ernest Hemingway, he came up with the term drink someone under the table. 6 hours. Well, see, Rick in Mongoose Traveler First Edition, this was discussed during the playtest, which I had nothing to do with. I wish I did, but I wasn't there. When you do your tat, when you roll for the skill task thing, you do your test check. One of the dice that you roll is also the die. You roll two different colored dice when you roll a 2d6, and you decide which die is going to be the hour die, the time die. So when you roll your 2d6, let's say you say the black die is the time die. So whatever the black die rolls up, that's how many hours it's going to take to do the task. So every skill listed in Mongoose Traveler First Edition has this 1 to 6 number, along with the difficulty for the task. So people say, what's the 1 to 6 for? Well, we left it in there, so it's optional. If you want to use the hour thing, you can roll a die, or you can decide one of your dice is the time die, or you can do some other method to determine maybe the effect based on the effect of the roll. The effect of the roll, that would be how many hours it takes, plus or minus 6 hours, whatever. But you can't use the effect unless you know already how many hours it would take to do the thing. But so they left this 1 to 6 thing in there, but they never really explained what it was for, because Mongoose, being what it is, releases games before they're finished being playtest. Just releases them into the wild. So when they were playtesting the Mongoose Traveler Second Edition, for some reason, I'm not sure what it was. Matthew would set a deadline. Hey, you guys need to settle this so we can print it out for the printers. And I would always say, I need 1 more week. I did that for like a month and a half. But I wanted the game to be written correctly, properly, no typos, no weird ambiguous meanings in it, because I wanted to buy the game. I really wanted to buy this game. I read the play test rules, and I didn't really have to play test the rules to know it was a good game. I just, this is good stuff. And he would send me more pages, and I'm like, yes, keep them coming, keep them coming. And I would send him back retyped pages with corrections and stuff. Yeah. And because I wanted to buy the game. I mean, everyone thought, oh, we're gonna get free games. That's why everyone else was in the playtest, because they thought they were gonna get a free copy of the hardcover for being a playtester. And I'm like, no. Hardly anyone even plays Mega or Mongoose Traveler. He's not gonna give out free copies to everybody. That's crazy. And he didn't. We had to buy our own. I think he gave out a free PDF. And I'm like, thank you, but fuck it. I want the hardcover, so I bought a hardcover. Oh, Shadow took off. Nope, Shadow's still there. He says he's. Oh, the other Sean. Sean took off. Okay. Yeah. Oh, yeah. I need to take off too soon because I have to get up at 4 in the morning. Crossing 3, Jack of all trades 2. Well, yeah. If you have Jack of all trading, if you have a Jack of all trades 2. Right? Is that the song that's sung by just one guy? Not the whole band? Maneuver. That's the one I use, I think. Human, let us proceed to drink mass quantities. Kevin had to go. Pew, pew, pew. We are here. We are here. We are here. We are here. I need to eat something. Cat suits? Man, I'm like half an hour behind you guys. I'm catching up. I'm catching up real quick here. Eight or nine. What is this? California time? You're welcome. Okay. Eight or nine. You guys didn't start at 8 or 9. It was like 11 o'clock when you guys started. I think you guys had a technical difficulty when you started or something. Oh, yeah. Shadow is still here. I count as one of the people watching this show, so I'm going to quit out of mine. Pew! So we get a more accurate count for the live stream. So I did Gunner. Now I have to do turrets. Turrets. Okay, so what do I call turrets? Gunnery turrets or something? Where's the Marines? They usually have these things. Do they have it? I'm not seeing it. What about Navy? Did the Navy have it? Army? Did Army have? No, they don't have that stuff. Who has turrets? Yeah, this is what I'll do. I'll just do a search for it. Turret. Find that. Turret gunnery. Okay, turret gunnery is now turrets. We'll replace that one. Turrets, no. No, doing it wrong. Turrets. Turrets. Oh, only one? Okay. So Navy has that. They got turrets, and now I have to do artillery. Who has artillery? Speak up now. So, artillery. Okay, let's put this here. And then this one. Copy, paste. So, artillery gunnery is now artillery. Replace all. Boom. Next, we got screens. These are like energy screens, defense screens, that kind of thing. Shields. So, what does a screen look like in my game? Ship screens. So, ship screens is now screens. God, the Navy has everything like that. Capital weapons. Who has that? Anyone? Anyone? Oh, capital weapons is still just capital weapons. Navy has it too. Gun combat. What did I call it back in the day? Do I have gun combat? Gun? Is it just called gun? Gun fighting. Gun fighting! Everyone was gun fighting. So gun fighting is now gun combat. Next is slug rifle. I have slug rifle already, I think. Let's make sure. I don't have a slug rifle. Oh. Slug rifle. I have slug rifle. Slug pistol. Do I have that one? Yep. Shotgun. Do I have a shotgun? Yes. Energy rifle. Yes, I have all that. Heavy weapons. Do I have heavy weapons? I do. Do I have launchers? I will now. What do I have? Heavy launchers. Heavy launchers are now called launchers. Next, we have man portable artillery. And do I have artillery anywhere? I do. So, portable artillery. Is now man portable artillery. Okay. Next. Field artillery. Oh, man. I know I don't have that. I'm pretty sure I don't. Oh, I do. So I don't have to fix that one. Next, we have investigate. And I think I called it investigating. Yep. So investigating is now investigate. Only one person had that, and that was an agent career. Jack of all trades, don't need to fix that. This is taking forever. This is going to take forever. I'm only halfway through my skills. How long's this video been going on for? Three hours. I see you guys later.